Salamat po sa mga taong nagbabahagi ng salita ng Diyos sa social media. Lagi ninyong sineshare yung mga homily namin dito. Salamat sa inyo. Baka hindi ninyo alam, yung binabahagi ninyo na salita ng Diyos ay nakapagbibigay ng liwanag sa isang taong dumaraan sa dilim.
Gandang tanghali po sa inyong lahat. And this liturgy is a votive mass in honor of the Blessed Mother. And today, as we gather to honor the Blessed Virgin Mary, as we heard in the Gospel, she is a woman whose life exemplifies true blessedness. But the question is this, what does it really mean to be blessed? Jesus, in today's Gospel, answering to that woman from the crowd that said, "Blessed is the womb that carried you and the breast at which you nurse," he is teaching us the way to true blessedness. As Jesus said, "Rather, blessed are those who hear the word of God and observe it." Jesus, while acknowledging his mother's blessedness, being the chosen one of God to be the mother of the Savior, reveals to us a deeper truth about being blessed. And so that will be our points for reflection this Saturday. Ano ba ang tunay na pagpapala? What is true blessedness in our journey of Christian life? First lesson that we could learn from this very short gospel, true blessedness is not found in biological connection, but in spiritual kinship. The woman in the gospel focuses too much on the physical reality of Mary's motherhood, that indeed she is the biological mother of Jesus. However, Jesus elevates our understanding. He reminds us that true kinship, that kind that leads to lasting blessedness, isn't about shared DNA, but it is about our shared faith and intimacy to God. Kaya kahit kamag-anak mo ang Santo Papa, kadugo mo ang mga santo o santa, kung hindi ka naman napapababilang no, sa mga taong malalapit sa Diyos, If you are not part of God's family by embracing His word and living it out, then you will not be truly blessed. Kaya ang tanong sa atin ngayon, what do we prioritize? Social circles or familial ties or our spiritual kinship? Naalala ko nung ako'y naging pare, dumami ang mga kamag-anak ko. Siguro, ang kanilang pakiramdam, and I'm happy about it, they are proud na meron silang kamag-anak na pare. But, you know, it's not about biological connection, but it's about your personal and intimate connection with God. that will bring about true blessings in your life. Second, that we could learn from this very short gospel, true blessedness lies not in special titles, but in our obedience to God. Wala sa mga titulo, no, na ibibigay sa iyo, mga award, recognition na igagawad sa iyo. Ang tunay na biyaya ay ang pagsunod sa Diyos. We know Mary is often given honorary titles. Kaya nga ang haba ng litany of Loreto, the litany of the Blessed Virgin Mary. All of them are titles of Mary. But I tell you, Mary's true greatness and blessedness lies not in these titles, but in her humble obedience to God's will. In fact, she didn't seek accolades. She didn't desire any prestige. She just wanted to listen and obey God's will in her life. Kaya nga, tandaan nyo yung kanyang fiat, her yes to God. It wasn't about achieving status. No? Wow, oo ako kasi magiging nanay ako ng tagapagligtas. It's not about that. Hindi siya napa-oo dahil sa mga pribilehiyo. Kaya siya umoo because that is her way of faithfulness, her language of love to God. Kaya suriin din natin yung ating mga sarili. Ang hinahanap ko ba lagi? No, papuri, pagkilala ng mga tao. I hope that it's enough for us deep within that I feel blessed even though people do not recognize me. Even people do not know me. Even I do not become a rock star. It's okay. As long as deep within I know I am faithful to God. I am obedient to the Lord. Truly blessed ka kapag ka masunurin ka sa kalooban ng Diyos. Panghuli, what is the source of true blessedness as we see in the life of Mary? True blessedness is not in gaining but in offering. Wala sa pagtanggap, sa pagkakaroon, ang tunay na pagiging pinagpala ay mararamdaman at mararanasan kapag ikay nagbibigay, kapag ikay nag-aalay. And Mary's life is precisely like that. She faced hardship, uncertainty, and even persecution. But she never wavered in her faith. Her willingness to offer her life in service to God will always be there. Her blessedness flowed from her selflessness, her willingness to put the needs of others before her own. Kaya nga, kung babalikan nyo yung istorya ng visitation, anong sabi ni Elizabeth sa kanya? Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. But in that story, the blessedness of Mary truly lies in her compassionate, kind heart for her cousin Elizabeth. That's why after that, she chose to stay to minister to the needs of her cousin. Pwede naman niyang sabihin, nanay na ako ng Diyos eh, bakit ako maglilingkod? Pero yun ang kadakilaan ni Maria, Yun ang tunay na pagpapala ni Maria, na hindi sa kanyang tinanggap na susukat, kundi sa kanyang pagbibigay. Hindi sa laki ng kanyang tinanggap na biyaya, kundi sa laki ng biyaya na kanyang ibinahagi ang tunay na pagpapala. Kaya nga, tanungin natin yung mga sarili natin. Are we consumed by a desire to acquire more, to achieve more, to gain more comfort and security? I hope we already realize the need to give up our time, our resources, or even our personal desire and offer it to God in service to others. My dear brothers and sisters, napakaikli nung ebanghelyong binasa natin ngayong araw. Pero kung pagninilayan natin, pagdarasalan natin, ipinapakita nito sa atin yung tunay na daan sa pagpapala. Ano ulit yung tatlong yon? True blessedness is not found in biological connection, but in spiritual kinship. Second, true blessedness lies not in special titles, but in obedience to God. And lastly, true blessedness is not in gaining, but in offering. As we celebrate this votive mass in honor of the Blessed Mother, let us ask for her intercession that we may follow her example, embracing humility and faithfulness to God, obedience to God's will, and selflessness on our journey towards true and lasting blessedness. Amen.